David Zinczenko, he knows a lot about these things. He's been on the program before. Talking about the best foods to fuel our bodies, he knows about this. He was editor-in-chief of Men's Health for more than a decade. And he's got this new book, Eat It to Beat It. You should read it. And David, you know, good morning to you. You know, do you know what you and I have in common?
What's that?
We both get a lot of grief for telling people what not to eat. We're sort of the grim reapers of diet. And people don't like to hear that.
I'm constantly bumming people out.
I know, me too. But, you know, some of this is important information and people need to hear it. But you also say you can eat the foods you love, lose weight, and still keep it off.
Yeah, and that is the entire premise of Eat It to Beat It. One of the things that I wanted to do is have a plan that was reasonable, that was realistic, that everybody could follow, because that's the problem. Diets are really restrictive, food's confusing, weight loss is hard. I know, I was a chubby kid. So in this case, I scoured all the restaurant menus. I went aisle by aisle through the supermarkets, because your average supermarket is 50,000 items and they're all trying to convince you that their products are good for you. And I put it all into Eat It to Beat It so that you could lose a lot of weight without ever dieting.
It's a great book. Again, people should read it. And one of the things that strikes me is you're led to believe certain things based on the title of the restaurant or the type of food, that it's healthy. And you believe other things are unhealthy. And those two things may not necessarily be true. And especially when you're out to eat, for example. So you one of the things you looked at was the best, if you will, hot breakfasts, lunches, and dinners. What would you find there?
Well, so, for example, you can go to a restaurant like Panera Bread, and you can get a breakfast power egg sandwich on whole grain, which is 340 calories. It's great. It's got a really nice blend of protein and fiber, low in calories, real egg, which is great because a lot of eggs out there are egg blends,
right.
And that's sort of creepy, and there's a lot of weird stuff in our food these days, but that's a really, really great one. The yolk is packed with vitamins, so I recommend that. It's a great way to start your breakfast, much better than like 1,500-calorie pancakes, which it's just all empty calories, sugar and fat.
It's amazing how the difference in calories. So you said 340 calories for that sandwich. There are breakfasts out there where you can get your entire calorie allotment just in the breakfast alone. What about lunch?
Yeah, well, for lunch, you could go to a place like Wendy's. You could have fast food. You could have a junior deluxe cheeseburger, which is only 350 calories. It's pretty low in sodium. The tough thing for consumers is that, you know, the food has blown up these days. Everything's supersized. There are 1,500-calorie cheeseburgers out there. And, you know, that 1,000-calorie difference or 1,100-calorie difference is a third of a pound of body fat that you would have to either work off or learn to live with.
You know, you're absolutely right. And, you know, I think a lot of people are going to be surprised to see Wendy's up there. But this idea that if you can eat smaller amounts and just it takes a little bit for your stomach to catch up to your brain, that in fact you've had enough food. But instead, if you eat the, you know, multiple pound cheeseburger, you're going to feel stuffed, you're going to feel terrible, and then you're obviously going to pay the price with those calories. What about dinner, quickly?
Well, dinner, you could have a pizza. Again, you could have your favorite foods and still lose weight. Yeah, we really like the Pizza Hut's Veggie Lovers, 180 calories per slice. It's got a hand-tossed crust. The thinner the crust, the thinner you. So we really like that, particularly, again, when you look at some of the really fatty, highly caloric pizzas that are out there that just make it really hard to stay on any kind of reasonable diet plan.
And, you know, and if you want to see the worst in each category as well, who doesn't want to see that? You can log on to CNNHealth.com. We're going to have a big reveal there from David. Appreciate having you on the program.
Thanks, Dr. Gupta.